With the end of the epidemic, more people are starting to travel again. For international travel, a universal travel adapter is essential. And today we got this adapter from MOMAX. Unlike the traditional one, it's equipped with a 35W USB-C PD port on the side. The red packaging is somewhat like the OnePlus. It can support iPad, iPhone, Switch, and Android phones. But it cannot activate TV mode for Switch. Flip to the back, all specs info are printed here. We'll talk about it later. Open the front cover, here are the detailed instructions for users to start quickly. And then take out the travel adapter from the box. One word 35W is printed below the front AC socket. It represents two critical features of this product. You can insert the AUS, US, EU, and UK plug on the front. You can also use those three toggle switches to switch between AUS, US, EU, and UK plug. A slight twist can turn the US plug into the AUS plug. The 35W PD USB-C port is on the side. It also has two USB-C and two USB-A ports at the bottom, much better than competitors. After connecting to the power supply, the LED indicator in the middle will light up. Let's take a closer look at the specs info. Model is UA9. The AC part can support up to 2500 watts, and the DC part can support input of 100 to 250 volts, 50 or 60 is 0.8 amp. The output power for a single port can be up to 35 watts, 15 watts, and 12 watts. The output power for two ports can be up to 20 watts and 50 watts. Finally, the output power won't exceed 20 watts for all ports. There are two 10 amp fuses inside. Even if the fuse burns out, you can immediately replace it with a spare one. The size of this travel adapter is about 54 by 53 by 71 mm, and the weight is about 148.6 grams. The overall size is similar to a 135W GaN charger. It can be packed into your bag or suitcase easily. The PowerZKM002C shows the USB-C one supports FCP, SCP, AFC, PD3.0, QC4+, PBS protocols. And it also supports 4 fixed videos of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 15V, 2.33A, 20V, 1.75A, and a set of PBS. The other 4 ports only support DCP and Apple 2.4A protocols. Next, we're gonna test its charging compatibility. For most PD devices, the charging power can be more than 30 watts or the highest charging speed the device can achieve. But for some Android phones, the current cannot exceed 2A, so the power is under 18 watts. As for the other two USB-C ports and two USB-A ports, the voltage cannot exceed 5 volts, so the power is under 15 watts. You can pause to view our test results. When charging 5 devices at the same time, the total power is about 20 watts. Those two devices are basically not charging. We also tested the charging performance when charging 3 or 2 devices. The real-time power shows the voltage cannot exceed 5 volts. Next, we'll use it to fully charge the iPhone 14 Plus. Here is the charging curve made by the PC software of KM003C. The peak power is about 26 watts at 17 minutes. Then the power will fluctuate with the current between 13 to 26 watts, which is pretty weird. We can obviously see the voltage drop from 9 volts to 5 volts, which means the end of the fast charging. After that, the charging power gradually drops to almost zero. It takes 2 hours and 6 minutes to be fully charged. We also plot it into another curve to see how fast it can be. It can charge the iPhone 14 Plus to 50% in 26 minutes and 80% in 51 minutes. It also reaches 100% in 2 hours and 6 minutes. As for the standby power part, the power consumption at 220 volts, 50Hz is 0.071 watts and 0.049 watts at 110 volts, 60Hz, which is about 0.62 and 0.43 kilowatts hour in 1 year respectively. So you do not need to worry about the waste of the electricity. In the conversion efficiency test, the conversion efficiency varies from 87.06% to 92.08% at 220 volts, 50 Hz. The conversion efficiency varies from 87.16% to 91.34% at 110 volts 6 years. Even the lowest value can reach more than 87% and some can even reach 92%. That's pretty high. Next, let's test its ripple. The lower ripple means better quality. Firstly, let's check out its ripple without load. When the output is 20 volts 0 amp, the highest ripple is 83.2 millivolts peak to peak and 79.6 millivolts peak to peak respectively. When the output is 5 volts 0 amp, the lowest ripple is 37.2 millivolts peak to peak and 35.6 millivolts peak to peak respectively. Then move to the ripple test when loaded. The ripple at 220 volts 50 Hz is higher than 110 volts 6 Hz in all 4 outputs. Like the no load, the highest and lowest ripples correspond to 20 volts and 5 volts respectively. The maximum ripple is close to 200 millivolts peak to peak, which is higher than some high power chargers. Not very good. Next, we're gonna put the charger into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank and let it output 35 watts throughout the test. After an hour, we got the maximum temperature. Under 220 volts 50 Hz, the front is 66.2 degrees Celsius and the back is 51.7 degrees Celsius. Moving on to the 110 volts 6 Hz, the maximum temperature on the front and back is 62.2 degrees Celsius and 54.3 degrees Celsius respectively. According to the IEC 62368, the maximum temperature of plastic cannot exceed 77 degrees Celsius, so it complies with the standard. Well, that's all tests for this 35W universal travel adapter from MOMAX. It has a 35W USB-C port that can support PD protocol, which can improve its charging compatibility. And the other 4 USB ports can also charge your other devices when traveling. It also has good performance in standby power test and conversion efficiency test. But the maximum temperature and ripple are not controlled very well. Okay, that's all for today's video. Don't forget to drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!